Agricultural engineers at Clemson University have developed technologies to tell farmers exactly where to apply fertilizers to their hay fields and how much is needed to maximize profits. One technology installs on a round hay baler's hydraulic kicker and weighs round bales as they are ejected. The other uses ultrasonic sensors that mount on the tongue of any baler and continuously measure height of the windrow as the harvester rolls through the field. Clemson Ag engineer Kendall Kirk discussed the technology at the recent hay production workshop at the university's Edisto Research and Education Center.
One of our key objectives in this, the whole time since we've started working on this project, is to build a technology that was not only cheap, of course we're paying attention trying to make an accurate product as well, but we wanted to be an inexpensive product where you can get that return on investment from it. In addition to that, we wanted to be a product that will work on any baler. So round baler, square baler, large square baler, small square baler. This is not dependent on any internal mechanism on the baler. What we're looking at is the windrow.
The information collected would enable growers to map the specific high or low yielding sections of a field and replace blanket fertilizer applications with variable rate treatments based on the needs of the field.
The concept is that you'll get a totalizer on there. So every field you come out of, you know the tonnage you pulled off of that field. And therefore, you know the fertilizer that you should be putting back to that field. What I'm showing you here is under application and over application. So if it's red, I under applied a nutrient, and I'm showing you there by how much. Okay, so in the highest yielding areas of the field, I'm under applying nitrogen per cutting by 30 pounds the acre. What do you think happens if I put that 30 pounds an acre to that spot in the field and it's got sufficient moisture? It's probably gonna bring my yield up. In the yellow area, since it's a blanket application to meet my average yield, and that's roughly what we do out here, in the yellow area, I'm meeting the requirements. But in the red area there, in the green area in this case, what was the lower yielding area, I've actually over-applied my nutrients. And so I'm wasting what I'm putting out there. The plant's not using it because the yield's not being made.
Graduate research assistant Perry Loftus, who is working with Kirk on the project, said hay is the only major commercial crop in the United States without a broadly implemented yield monitor. Loftus and Kirk estimate the potential increases to yield or decreases to input costs would allow growers to recoup their investments in the technology in just 1 year.
The great thing about applying precision agriculture to hay and forage is that we've already learned a lot of hard lessons in row crop arena, right? We already know, for instance, when we first had yield monitors available in row crops, nobody knew what to do with them. And even if you did know what to do with them, you didn't have the technologies in place to say, make a variable rate application. Well, we've got that now, thanks to row crops and thanks to kind of them taking the lead on that. And so the prices for these technologies have really come down as well.